Good morning students, welcome to the online classes. In today's video, we are going to learn about email writing. So let's go. Email means electronic mail, means we can send mail via electronic. It is a method of exchanging digital messages across internet or computer networks. It is the quickest way to communicate in writing. Emails can be grouped into three categories, like formal emails, semi-formal emails, informal emails. Formal emails. The formal emails are sent to people whom the writer doesn't know. Thus, you don't know who is going to receive your email. Semi-formal emails. Semi-formal emails are usually sent to people whom the writer knows, or to your colleagues or to your co-workers. Clear? Thereafter, informal emails. Informal emails are sent to friends, relatives, or any close acquaintances. So, contents of email. Email messages consist of two major sections. One is header, another is body. Header contains your sender, means your ID, your email ID. Then receiver, means who is going to receive your email. Then subject, then date and time. Body, that contains the message, whole message. It can be formal or informal. That is depending on the purpose. Suppose you are writing to your friends. So it is an informal message. Suppose you are writing to any official departments. So it is a formal emails. So there is an email format. So what are the systematic order of the email? First of all is two. So a complete plausible email ID. Like I have given my email ID, amirmahapatra@gmail.com. Then subject. Must be appropriate to the given topic. Then salutation. Salutations are your like dear sir, ma'am, dear Mr. Sharma, dear Mr. Ray, like this. Then opening sentence of your email, not of your address. Then body, means what your message contains. Then closing sentence, means your wish, your hope, your request, that kind of sentence. Then last one, subscription. Like yours faithfully, yours sincerely, yours obediently. So some of the points you have to remember while writing an email. First, when writing formal emails, do not use contractions such as I am, didn't, you will, you are. So don't use contraction forms in formal email. Second, email ID should be written in lowercase or small letters, and without any space between letters, remember. The tone must be formal. Formal means, tone means that whatever you are communicating, words or phrases you are using, that should be official language. Then the message is to be conveyed using clear and simple language. So whatever message you are trying to give through the email, it should be clear and use simple language. And punctuation is to be maintained. So what are the salutations are there for different email format? For formal email, you are using salutations like dear sir or madam, dear Mr. Sharma, dear Mr. Rao. Okay. For leave taking, for the formal email, yours faithfully, yours obediently, yours sincerely. You can use three of them. That doesn't mean dear sir means you have to write yours faithfully. That doesn't mean same. You can use any of these, but according to the your email, your purpose of email. Then semi-formal email. Salutations like dear and your friends, your co-workers, first name, not full. And leave taking should be like that. Thanks, best regards, yours, like this. Then informal email. Informal email salutations like hello Pratik, hi Ravi, So hello, hi. So these are the words you can use while writing informal email. And leave taking like best wishes, all the best. Okay, these kind of phrases or words you can use while writing formal, semi-formal or informal. Then I have collected some of the vocabulary. Informal, we say thank you. Informal, we say thanks. Formal, I would like to apologize for. Informal, sorry for. Formal, I would appreciate it if you were something like that. Then you can say, can you help me like that? Okay, so rest of the sentence you will write according to your propose, according to the situation. Would you happen to know? Do you know? Unfortunately, I will not be able to. I can't. I would rather not. I don't want. So these kind of that you can use while writing formal emails and informal emails. You can note it down in your notes so that you can remember it while writing formal or informal emails. So here I have one sample question for you. Write an email to the principal of a neighboring school informing about the competition and request to send a team to participate in the competition. Okay, so you have to write an email to the neighboring schools to inform about some competition and also you request them. See? So here I retain the four email. First I retain the one someone school's email ID, principalpublicschool@gmail.com. That is all retained in lower case without any space between letters. Then subject, indoor school dance competition. I retain only phrases. You can write one sentence also. Then salutations, dear sir. Our school is going to organize an inter-school dance competition for the students of classes 8 and 9th. It will be held on 7th July 2020 from 10:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. in the auditorium hall of Carmel Convent School. Please send a team from your school to participate in the competition. It will be a group dance competition with each team comprising not more than 8 students. They can follow any one of the following styles like folk, classical, contemporary, salsa, hip hop. Clear? Then your closing sentence. We look forward to your school's participation in the competition. Then thanking you. Yours faithfully, subscription, then your name and designation, Rakesh Agrawal, Secretary, Dance Club. I hope you understand very well how to write the email and what are the email formats, how to write an email ID. So keep these points in your mind while writing an email. Thank you students for watching the video. I hope you understand very well how to write an email. So we'll meet you in my next video with some exciting topics. Till then, see you, take care, bye.